When you first learn algebra, you work with basic linear equations with just one variable, and then you solve the equation and usually get one solution, or there might be the situation where it's an identity and there's infinitely many solutions, or there may be no solutions if you get a contradiction, but usually there's one solution. Now we're going to work with linear equations in two variables. So it's an equation that has two variables. There's still no exponents on the variables, and just one at a time. So some examples are x plus y equals 5, y equals 2x minus 1, 2y equals negative 3x. The difference is each of these equations has infinitely many solutions. In fact, any ordered pair that makes the equation true is a solution. Let's see if we could just get a couple quick solutions to this first one. So I want to write an ordered pair, xy, and remember that x is the number that goes first in the parentheses and y would be the second number. So a solution might be two numbers that add up to 5. How about 3, 2? Can you think of another one? How about 1, 4? How about if we switch it and do 4, 1? So these are just quickly three solutions that I could come up at the top of my head. But there's actually infinitely many solutions. You could pick any number for x, and there's going to be some value of y that goes along with that x to make the equation true. So let's go back to this equation, x plus y equals 5, and let's again write some ordered pairs that make this equation true. So we came up like with x was 2 and y was 3. We were able to do this on the top of our head, right? And 1 and 4, 4 and 1. How about if one of them was 0? Like if x was 0, y could be 5. How about, let's say, if x was 6, then y could be negative 1 is what y would have to be to get back to 5. So these are some ordered pair solutions. Only 5 of the infinitely many ordered pair solutions. It's impossible to write all of the solutions, right? Because you can't write an infinite number of ordered pairs. So there's a graphical representation. What you could do is take a graph. You want to get graph paper, for instance. And remember, you have x and y. And if I make some tick marks here, you can put some of these ordered pairs on your graph. All right, so get out some graph paper and try that. All right, so if I were going to do this, I'm going to show you what it would look like if I had a little bit more accurate looking graph. Okay, so we have 2, 3. We have 1, 4. We have 4, 1. We have 0, 5. And we have 6, negative 1. What we want to make sure is when we do this that all of our points should end up being on a straight line. By the way, you could have fractions involved too. Let's say you tried 3 and a half, 1 and a half. That's an ordered pair. And if I was going to graph that, 3 and a half, 1 and a half, I see that's also on the straight line. So those are only 6 solutions of this. The way to represent all the solution is to draw a line through all the points. So keep in mind, all of the ordered pairs on this line are solutions to x plus y equals 5. So the line is a graphical way to show all the solutions to x plus y equals 5. One way to sort of check yourself is to find another point that the line's going through and make sure it's really a solution. So, for instance, I see a point right here, and that's the ordered pair 3, 2. And if I plug that in to x plus y equals 5, putting in 3 for x and 2 for y, 3 plus 2 does equal 5. So it sort of checks that I am going through the correct ordered pairs. The second equation I gave you was y equals 2x minus 1. So I'm just picking four ordered pairs and asking you if any of these are solutions. So what you want to do is plug in the x and y value into this equation and find out which of these are solutions, put yes or no. Let's see, when we put in 2 for x, does that work? If I put in 2 for x and I put in 3 for y, does 3 equal 4 minus 1? Yes. So that's a solution. Let's try the next one. I'm plugging in 3 for the x, and I'm plugging in 7 for the y. Is 7 equal to 6 minus 1? No. Not a solution. How about 0, 2? I'm plugging in 0 for x, and I'm plugging in 2 for y. Is 2 equal to 0 minus 1? No. Be careful that you plug in the correct number for x and the correct number for y. And let's see, plugging in negative 1 for x, 2 times negative 1, and minus 1, and then negative 3 for y. All right, so is negative 3 equal to negative 2 minus 1? Yes. All right, so we found out that these two are not solutions, but we found two that were solutions. So let's go ahead and plot those points over here. 2, 3, if I want to see the rest of the solutions, if I was curious what the graphical representation would be, and negative 1, negative 3. All right. Well, there's only two points. I hope I didn't make a mistake. Let's just pick another ordered pair. So let's see what would happen if I put in 0 for y. So we go over here. I'm sorry, if we're going to put in 0 for x. Putting in 0 for x, I get 2 times 0 minus 1. So that gives you 0 minus 1, which is negative 1. All right, so we have another ordered pair to plug in there. 0, negative 1, and excellent. It looks like it's on the line as well. So our next step, if we want to see all the solutions in a graphical way, is we draw a straight line through those points. Always get out something straight to draw the straight line. Now let's go ahead and check one of the ordered pairs this goes through and see if it also makes the equation true. So let's see, I see an ordered pair right here. That's the ordered pair 1, 1. And so let's see, if I plugged in 1 for x and 1 for y, I get 1 equals 2 times 1 minus 1. And that's true, so it looks like I do have the right graph. So if you were also asked to draw the graph, or write the solutions graphically to this equation, you could just draw the line. The first question I asked you was just which of the following ordered pairs of solutions, and if that's all you're asked, all you have to do is put yes or no. The other equation I had at the beginning of this video was 2y equals negative 3x. So let's say I was asking you this question. Is 4 negative 6 a solution of 2y equals negative 3x? How would we do this? We're going to plug in what number for y? So we're going to see. What number are we going to plug in for y? Negative 6. And what number are we going to plug in for x? 4. And the question is that a true statement? Negative 12 equals negative 12. So what's your answer? Yes. Let's ask another question. How about you try this one? Is negative 6, 4 a solution of 2y equals negative 3x? Try that, see what you get. All right, this time I'm going to plug in what for y? I'm going to plug in 4 for y. Remember, it's the order pair is x, y. So we're plugging in negative 6 for x and 4 for y. So I'm plugging in negative 6 for x. Now what does that give me? 8 is equal to 18? I don't think so. So the answer to that one is no. All right, here's one more for you to try on your own. Is 5 negative 1 a solution of 2x minus y equals 9? Put the video on pause and try it. All right, so let's plug in. What are we going to plug in for x? 5, and here's the tricky part, minus, and what are we plugging in for y? Negative 1. Don't just put minus 1, put minus negative 1. And the question is, Is this true? So let's see. 10, right? That's 2 times 5. Minus negative 1 is plus 1. So you know what? No. 11 is not 9. All right. If we were asked to graph the line, we would have to find several solutions. But we're just checking to see if these are solutions or not.